How to customize WooCommerce My Account page for free WordPress tutorial. Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. I hope you all are doing great and are having an amazing and absolutely incredible day. I bring you back with yet another video, and in this video we're going to be talking about how you can customize WooCommerce My Account page totally for free in the easiest, most simplest way possible. And this is going to be a really easy, really simple, and really fun tutorial to work with. So please do make sure to fully watch this video till the end to get the whole depth and detail and analysis of how things work. So yeah, basically to start things off, let's discuss a few things off the bat. Obviously, my account page is going to be the page where you're going to give details about your account, you know, your socials or different things. Now in that my account page, people can also find access to their own accounts and their own different dashboards and all. So obviously you're going to make some different analysis and editings to that. Now the My Account page can be accessed through the WooCommerce settings, but it can't be, you could say, created through it. Now you're going to create the My Account page through the Pages section in WordPress that I'm currently on right now. Then you're going to edit it through, you know, any basic drag and drop builder that your page has. It could be WordPress's very own editor, or even it could be, you know, something like Elementor or some stuff that you've added. And then finally, then we're going to be using WooCommerce to designate it as an account page, because WooCommerce is the one that designates it. So let's say if a person wants to go through to their account page after some type of transaction, then WooCommerce will know that, yeah, this person needs to go to this page because we've designated it as the accounts page. So yeah, basically we just need to understand that when we're starting off with actually working with WooCommerce as your account page for free. So to obviously start things off for yourself, what we are going to be doing is we're going to go over ahead to WooCommerce over here. And over here, we're going to create two pages for ourselves. So I'm going to click on add new page. And once you click on add new page, it's going to load some things up for us. So we're just going to wait for it to do that. And here it brings us to add a page. Now in add a page, what you're going to want to do is you're going to pick a predefined layout or start with a blank page for yourself. In my case, I am going to go with a blank page, okay, because obviously for an account page has different workings in it. So I'm gonna edit it myself, click on add title, and I'm gonna add account page. There we go. And once you write in account page, from there on out you're gonna click on publish and everything should be good to go from there. So yeah, now you've created an account page for yourself, right? Like everything is created, everything is good, everything is done. Now, what are we going to do from here? You know, what needs to be done from here? From here, what you're going to need to do is basically we're going to go back, because obviously my page is now live. So I'm going to go back into my WordPress. Okay, I'm going to go into view pages. Now, from here is two things. First of all, we're going to edit it. Second of all, we are going to tell WooCommerce that, hey, this is my page. This is my account page to be specific. And, you know, you're going to redirect people to this place if they're looking for the accounts page, or if you want to redirect them to the accounts page. So to do that, what you're going to do is you're going to come over to WooCommerce. And once you're into WooCommerce, you're obviously, if your store is upgraded and everything, all you're going to do from there on out, you're going to go into your settings of WooCommerce. Once you go into your settings, you're going to go to the advanced section of the settings. And once you've gone to the advanced section of the settings, from there on out, you're going to get options for page setup. Okay. And in the page setup option, you're going to get three different things. Okay. It's going to say cart page, checkout page, account page, and then it might say terms and service page for you. In some cases, it doesn't, but obviously that depends on your type of store and your region. Now, in my case, it says account page, cart page, checkout page. So obviously we're going to go with the account page. And once you've chosen the account page, then you're going to choose the page that you're going to make the account page. So obviously we've already created an account page for ourselves. So we're going to connect our account page from WooCommerce to our actual account page. So yeah, that basically does all the workings from WooCommerce aside. Now, what you're going to do is obviously you're going to go ahead and you're going to edit things. And to edit things, obviously, you're going to come over to your basic WordPress editor. Okay, you can also just go ahead and use your basic Elementor or any other website editor that you have. Okay, and working with that is pretty easy. Working with Elementor is pretty nice and easy. So you can go ahead with Elementor and it would make sense. But obviously, I'm going to stay here. And once we come here, what I'm going to do is, first of all, I'm going to change my page, okay? So to change your page, you're going to go over to plus. And once you go over to the plus section, obviously, we're going to want to lead ourselves to the different pages that we have, okay? And to go to the different pages, you are going to want to make sure to go and edit the different page that you want to go with. Now, this is obviously my home dashboard page. And I can go to a different page by clicking on this over here, and we're going to come to the account page that I recently created. Now, once you come over to the account page, obviously, you can go ahead and add different widgets in this by using the edit or customize or design section. And obviously, we're going to go ahead and start adding things in this. So, first of all, we're going to add some type of, paragraph, or better yet, obviously, it is an accounts page, right? So in the accounts page, either you could add an image, a cover image, or you could add some type of stack or column. You know, it all depends on you and the type of, account page you actually want to go with. You could also copy some, HTML or CSS code off of some other account page that you can add really easily. And, you can add a contact form in this as well. So let's say I'm gonna just drag and drop some type of contact form in my basic page. And once you've added a contact form, obviously what it's gonna do is it's gonna start asking details on the account page. And obviously using the contact form, the users are gonna input their details. So really fun and really easy stuff to get your head around. And it's just really good for when it comes to working with all these things. And you can add different tags. You can add different descriptive settings in those tags. And it's just really fun to, be working with all of this. So yeah, basically that is how you're going to customize your WooCommerce account page for free on WordPress in the easiest, most simplest way possible. Now, if you enjoyed watching that video till the end, please make sure to drop down a like and subscribe to this channel. And if you want to see more videos like this in the next video, please let me know down in the comments below and I'll be making more for you. But yeah, that's about it for this video. Thank you for watching all the way till the end, and I will be seeing all of you wonderful people next time. Have a great day. Goodbye.